In this video, you will learn how to create a responsive table with search and pagination capabilities in WordPress. You can change the number of records displayed on each page or turn off pagination to display all records. You can live search among records. For example, here we filter all Indian chess players. As you can see, this table has 100 records. You can change pagination or disable it completely. If you don't need the search bar, you can turn it off here. This table is fully responsive and is displayed correctly on mobile devices. To add a table in WordPress, you can use the table block. The problem of using table block is that you have to enter all the data in the table manually, and if the number of data in your table is large, this method will be very time-consuming. So we use another method. First, delete the table block. Go to Google Sheets or Microsoft Excel and select and copy the data you want. Now go back to WordPress and add a custom HTML block. Click on Preview. Make sure Custom HTML block is selected, then press the Ctrl plus V button. Now the custom HTML block will be converted into a table block and you can see your table data in WordPress. Update the page and check the result. Go to the link in the description. Copy this PHP code. By clicking on the copy button, this code will be copied. On the WordPress dashboard, go to Appearance, Theme File Editor and open the functions.php file. Remember, you must create a child theme before making any changes to functions.php. Otherwise, the applied changes will be lost after each update. Watch video number 1 on the channel to learn how to make a child theme. Paste the code into the functions.php and update the file. Now assign a class to your table. I assign the MyTable class to my table. Add a shortcode block. In the second line of the code, a shortcode example is placed. We copy it and use it. Change the class to my table. Change the pagination to your liking. I write the number 10. I will not change the value of the filter. If you do not need the search bar, set it to off. Now refresh the page and check the result. The table has been successfully added to the page and all its functionalities are working properly. That's it. If you do have any questions or comments about this, please put them below. If you liked this video and would like to see more like it, please subscribe, and I'll see you next time.